Welcome to what I hope is a pilot episode for a long series of videos to where I do some nice and cheap upgrades to my Jeep. More like visual upgrades. I'm not gonna like do a LS swap or lift at 6 inches. This is more cheap upgrades that you can do yourself. And this, I believe, is the best $20 spent on upgrading your Jeep JL. And let me show you it right here. And it's just a simple antenna replacement. You can buy these on Amazon or eBay, and they're all about the same for about $20. And they're to replace this ugly thing right here. I mean, this is a brand new car just off the factory, 2020, and it's got this 1980s, 1990s whip aerial antenna. What car today still has this kind of antenna? This is just ridiculous. It's ugly, it's hideous, and not even Jeep likes it. Look on any of Jeep's web pages, and they actually removed the antenna from all of their marketing. Even the last big announcement, the Mojave and the high altitude Jeeps on the showroom floor, they removed the antenna. So not even Jeep themselves like this. And that's why I think this right here is going to be the best $20 may is spent on your Jeep upgrade. So let's go ahead and do that right now. From what I understand, you can just twist this thing off. Well, it's going to be a little bit stubborn. And that's what this is for right here. And it just screws off real simple. And I'd like to really just get the address of the engineer that the thought that this would be a good idea and just send him every antenna that people take off of their Jeeps, because this is like one of the first upgrades anybody ever does to their Jeep, and it's definitely worth it. Now the question is, garbage or recycle? You know what? This thing's not even worthy being made into razor blades. Let's just toss in the garbage. Goodbye and good riddance. What the? All right, you are definitely a stubborn one. Okay. Away you go. Be gone. Son of a. What the? Go away. And stay. Okay, I'm done with this shit. You win, you win. You can become razor blades or something. I don't care. Just get out of my life. Go away. And stay away forever. All right, finally. I guess it just wanted to be recycled. All right, let's see what we're dealing with here. Just a standard antenna, and I believe this is the adapter for it. Kind of hard to do this with one hand, but hey, deal with the cards you're dealt with. Play with the cards you're dealt with. All right, screw this guy in. Nice and tight. And this guy in. There we go. And let's see how that looks. Much, much better. Very, very nice. Now, the important part is to see how it sounds. the... Alright, in all seriousness, jokes aside, this is one of the best upgrades. You can't even see the antenna over there. Just barely visible. And I've already gone and scanned through all my channels. I don't have any music playing because, well, copyright strikes and stuff. Being a new channel, I don't really want to mess with that stuff. And anyways, all my channels are coming in loud and clear, and I really noticed no difference between having the big aerial whip and this little 13-inch shorty right over there. So it seems like it really is like one of the best upgrades for your $20. One of the best first upgrades I honestly can recommend on the JL Jeep line. Well, if you made it this far, it means you like the content, and thanks for sticking with me. Make sure to hit the like if you did like it, and it helps justify it for me of spending 3 hours to screw in a 30-second antenna replacement. I also have a lot more content planned in the future, including one $20 tip that'll save you over $3,000. So you want to stick around for that, so hit the subscribe and you'll get notifications for when I update you. Also, kind of helps me justify it with the wife. So you might want to help me with that too, and I'll be able to do a lot more modifications. So catch you all on the other side, and keep the shiny side up.